I'm looking at the government's consultation plan about how they're going to get us out of this hole. And frankly, the news is not good there either, because they haven't come up with any detailed plans. And quite honestly, I think they would rather prefer the problem just to go away. But it won't go away, of course, and neither will the European Union, which has prosecuted Britain three times for its failure to observe the exceedances that they themselves set in the year 1999. Now, this needs to actually happen, otherwise the Britain will be fined. And the poor people of Britain will suffer twice. First of all, from breathing toxic, polluted air, which is killing 40,000 people in the UK every year. And secondly, because I'll have to pay the fine, because the government hasn't done anything about it. And that is big news. Well, it would be nice to think the government would do that. But in fact, if you think back to issues like nuclear energy, nuclear weapons, genetically modified foods. The Greens have been saying for years and years that these are not good ideas. And first of all, we were described as fanatics, as loonies. But actually, those notions now have become accepted. In the same way, look, you know, in Europe, there's 400,000 people a year dying or having their lives blighted by air pollution. Now, who wouldn't want to do something? It's not easy, but we need to actually take some action, because A, people are dying, B, it's costing us a fortune, and C, we are actually making a really desperate, unhappy lives for the children who are breathing that air in now. I mean, most of the pollution comes from transport, comes from vehicles. Most of the nitrogen oxide comes from diesel vehicles, which is why you get cities like Paris who are actually going to end diesel cars in their center. A lot comes from machinery, a lot comes from aviation, a lot comes from industry. But we need to actually tackle those sources, because otherwise it's not going to get any better. In fact, today, when we've actually been to that research station, which has got one of only two pieces of kit that measure these ultrafine particles, we find that it's going to be worse and worse and worse as the years go on. And who wouldn't want to do something? It is common sense. The Greens have to sort of come at it because it's a very big problem. And, you know, there's problems around, obviously, the way we travel. So we need to actually cut out reliance on fossil fuels in the vehicles. We need to use them under renewable energy. Ideally, we want to travel more sustainably. We want, you know, more buses, more bikes, more walking. We need to find these solutions. The way that we plan our cities and plan our transport. You know, do we really want to attract hundreds of thousands of cars into our cities? They're all causing congestion. They're all causing pollution. We need to find different solutions.